Let's tie this dragonfly. Pretty straightforward fly, but this foam, we want to take. I got the three pieces looped over. I'm going to shove this piece in that end, into that little corner there. And then I'm going to try to freehand tie this together. This can be a little tricky. Kind of grab the thread there with your thumb. Make a few passes here. And you can see I've got a lot of. I got a tag end there. We'll cut that up here in a moment. Now to hide that thread, I'm going to go in between these right here. I'm going to go in between these and then start my next pass. And that should hide those threads for us. So if you, let's get rid of that extra piece. You can see that's coming around the bobbin there. So I'm going to come in and cut that off right now. So you can see each body segment. There's no cross on this. If you watched my other video, you saw that there's a cross of thread on the top. This, we're hiding it by tucking this in, by crossing it over in between these pieces of foam. We're just going to keep doing this. Make eight segments here. Count those real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this will be my eighth one here. Now on this one, I'm going to put a half hitch around it. Might have to do this off camera just because of the size of all this. That half hitch will help hold that in place for now while I get the hook in place now. So I'm going to take the hook. If you go back to this, the original one we're looking at, that hook is buried in the body. So I'm just going to kind of bring this hook in here. I'm actually going to go in the bottom. Just see how much hook I've got here so I can kind of get a good idea of where the head's going to be. So I put that in here. And again, I'm trying just to go through one layer of foam. So poke that in there. And then I'm going to have it exit right through that next body segment that I would have made. I'll make that in a minute here. And now at this point, put this on the hook. On the vise. Okay. So now with that, we'll continue our body wraps. Couple more there. one more there. And now we've got to add in our legs and that wing material. So I'm going to take one of these. You notice there's kind of one in the front and one in the back on that, oops, on those legs. So just wrapped one there. I'm going to take this wing material, lay that in the middle, tie that down. Couple of wraps behind it to try to even out how it lays on that hook. You can see that this stuff is rolling real good on this hook. So at the end, I'm going to super glue that to kind of help hold it in place. And the final wrap, of course, will also help final body segment. But foam likes to spin on hooks, so super glue is great. Now we got one more leg to put on. Pull one more of those off. Now we're going to lay this back down and make one more wrap, one more body segment here. That in a minute. I'll take the whip finisher. Let's see if this whip finisher is big enough for this fly with that head on there still. Yeah, it's going to be a little tricky. Probably have to do this freehand here. Yeah, let's take that off. A couple of half hitches. Same idea as the whip finisher, just by hand here. Okay, now that's the tying part. Now we gotta clean it up. So I'm gonna come up here, I'm gonna cut off the wing material. I've got it looped on this side. At first, I'm just gonna cut it where the end of the loop is, because that's where my legs end. So it seems like a good place to start. If we need to, we can come back and cut it shorter again. So I'll cut that straight across. Make sure I get this extra one. Then on the bottom, do the same thing. The legs seem to be even when I tied them in. Okay, so now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to grab my super glue and I'm going to put a drop right back here where the hook was, trying to help lock that hook and the threads. Put a little there where the thread ended. And now let me go back to the original. See, he's got a little pointy head and some eyeballs. We're gonna do that part now. And you want to be careful because that super glue, of course, is going to try to lock your fingers to the fly and send you out to the fishes. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take a little bit of super glue. Just run it right in here. A little drop or two. A little here. And carefully try to hold these together without getting my fingers too much. Okay, that worked pretty well. I'm going to give that a moment to dry. as that's drying, I'm going to take and put the eyes on. Probably the best way, if you got a rotary vise, is to go like this. Put your drop of super glue, pick up the eyeball, and from the top, drop that on. Because those eyeballs are kind of hard to hold on to. I'm going to just trim up this other side real quick to make it even for that eye. Make a nice level spot to put it on. I'll drop a super glue. Eyes are almost as bad as trying to pick up tiny hooks. Such tiny eyes. But using that, putting it up like that, you can just come in from the top and let it sit there for a second while the super glue does its job. Now at this point, we just need to make the little point on the top of the head. So we're gonna come in with the scissors. And we're just gonna snip a little angle like that. Come in from the other side. Snip it like that. And there you have the dragonfly.